Hello again, everybody. Welcome back. Today is Friday, so it is Stardew Valley Day. I'm Tethys, and I've gone ahead and gotten a couple mods, as well as done a little bit of setup with the farm. So we've got a bunch of melons growing. We've got a mod here that lets us look up pretty much any information about anything in the game. So I've got some corn growing, got some coffee, blueberries, tomatoes, hot peppers. What we're trying to do right now is we're trying to finish the quality crops bundle, because that is going to be the biggest pain in the butt to finish in the community center. And if we finish that, we get a greenhouse, which is awesome because we're able to grow anything year round. Now, we're currently in summer still, so we do need a melon, a blueberry, and a tomato in order to finish that bundle, because otherwise we have to wait until summer next year, which really sucks. We want to get some gold quality melons, so hopefully higher quality fertilizer makes it easier for us to get those 5-star melons, and we need 5 of those. What we're also trying to do right now is trying to get the achievement for shipping one of everything in this list, and then we have to ship 15 of everything that is growable, except for tree items and forage items. So anything that is able to be grown aside from that needs 15 of those shipped. And then we need to ship 300 of one crop as well. So hopefully, with the amount of corn we've got growing, that will be easy to finish. I've also got some preserving bins up here, which increases the sell price of an item by 2.5. So right now, I've got some tomatoes sitting in there, because they sell for a pretty decent amount. Let me just take a look here at what they sell for again. Yeah, 66 times 2.5, so about 170. Yeah, 170 about. So that's really great to have. And right now, let's just take a quick peek. Order fortune is... Ooh, nope, that's not happening today. And storms are approaching. Okay, so let's get these watered. Oh, I've got the watering can in my inventory. Later. So we're gonna get these all watered up, because there's no point in making a sprinkler until we're able to use the better one, which, instead of it being watering one tile above, below, to the left and right, it will water all the tiles that are around it immediately. So, until that is usable, there's no point in spending any time making sprinklers. But once we do have sprinklers, it will be infinitely easier, and we can spend more time doing other things. Right now, I want to get to the 80th floor, at least, in the mines, because then we can hopefully get a fire quartz and finish off the boiler room. And that will unlock mine carts for us, which makes it much easier to get around, and cuts about an in-game hour of walking back home from the mines, because we can just hop on a cart in there and be at the bus stop already. We're also going to try and get a enough money for... Enough money for the bus complete repairs, and that's going to be about $45,000 for that, or in-game currency, or I don't know what it's called, it's just called G, so. Not quite sure what that is called, if it's gold or something. Alright, so we got those all watered. Ooh, preserving bin's finished. That gives us pickled tomatoes. It's pretty much, it's always pickled whatever you put in there, unless it's fruit, in which case it comes out as jelly, which we do actually need one of for the artisan bundle. We've already gotten an apple, which is awesome, because that's one less thing to worry about. If we can get honey, I don't know if we're high enough. Oh, we are high enough. Well, then why the heck haven't I made a tapper? Wood and copper. How much wood do we have? I don't think we have a lot right now, because I spent it using, or making those preserving bins. Okay, well, let's get one going. It's only 50 wood. And then we just need to find a maple tree. And they are usually a pain in the butt to find, just because of the fact they look so similar to the, oak. The oak trees. So what we'll do is we're gonna go to the forest that's underneath, that's, where Marnie lives, so that we can get, hopefully, maple trees there. But first we need the wood. So we're gonna get that first. Also, what's up here today? Not a whole lot, but if we break these, they'll give us a little bit of experience in mining. As you can see, I've got some experience bars up here, which is so much better. Just because of the fact it makes it actually show us what everything's giving this experience for. We already got a little bit of progress because of that, so it's totally worth it. We'll go check on our chickens in a minute. We're just going to go and get another 25 wood. We can cut the trees down here, and they do also regrow, so that's not a worry. I also found out that put your storage crates pretty much anywhere in town and in the mines and everything, so you could theoretically put a bunch of boxes in the mines, and then it will make it so that you can go back to the top, back up above ground, put all the stuff that you're carrying in there, and then you can go back down into the mines, which I did not know, which is awesome. What's that, a maple tree? Sweet. Pop that on there. Because I didn't see any closer pine trees. Also, have we just got spice berries? Oh, we only need to ship one? Perfect. And they get 35 energy, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to grab the other ones that are laying around. First, I want to take a look at this traveling card here, because they do occasionally sell the stuff that we need. Goat's milk. We are going to grab that. Why? Because we can make a cheese maker, and that cuts out the needing of the goat for the cheese. But we don't currently have the plans for a cheesemaker, because we need to get higher up in farming. I think it comes around level 6, so we'll just get experience by actually doing what we're doing right now, which is growing our crops. I'd also like to get a couple more tappers going, just because it takes a week for one harvest from a tree for its sap. And I'd like to make the most of it. There. Okay, we got a little lucky there, so we're not going to push our luck with that. If we come across another spice berry, that's a sweet pea. That's just some selling. If we come across another spice berry, we will chop down another tree. And hopefully it gives us enough wood for two tappers. Oh, there's a lot of maple down here. This looks like the maple section. And that's probably an oak. Yes, it is. this mod that we have is so useful. It basically, look up anything, and it's just so useful. It even tells you what you need for the community bundles when you, press F1 on it. Although, quite honestly, you really don't need that part, because you can just look it up in your inventory without having to go to the community center. But, you know, it doesn't hurt to have it. You never have too much help. Ooh, we were so close. Oh well, that still gives us enough for one more tapper. So we have to go get some copper. And while we're up there, we'll go and take a look at our chickens and see what they've produced for today. We've got a little bit of progress on the animal bundle. We did put one large brown egg. We need now one large white egg. And then we have to eventually upgrade the chicken coop so that we can hold ducks and get duck eggs. Okay, we need another 2 copper. And you'll notice I've got an extra of our crops right now. And that is because at level 8 or 7 or 8, or is it 9? I think 9. We get the seed maker, which when we put a crop in it, we're able to get 1 to 3 seeds in return. So it almost eliminates the need for going to Pierre's afterwards. Plus, it just means that you've got at least every seed that you can get in storage. Alright, so you got 2 small and 1 and 2 large. So I have to make sure I don't put... there. Okay, good. Alright, we've got a large white egg for the storage. Another thing I also learned is that once we get high enough in foraging, we learn the blueprint for the lightning rod, which I knew about that. But what you can do with the lightning rod is you put it in a patch of grass, and then your animals can't eat that grass, so it's constantly there to regrow the grass, which is just awesome. People are texting me. Always when I'm recording. Alright, what do we got in here again? Right. We've got a bunch of the hot peppers. We only need to ship 14 of them. And yeah, we don't need any of those for the community center, so let's sell 14 of these. Awesome. And we will just put the extras in here. Because then we're able to get more seeds. And if I remember correctly, no, they don't sell for more than a tomato. So, oh, another thing. I don't know if anybody else knows this, or at least if you guys know, but don't worry about putting in gold or silver star items into preserving bins and kegs and such, because that does not determine what you get back. So, for instance, if I put in a gold egg into the egg, the mayonnaise maker, it doesn't guarantee that I'm going to get the golden mayonnaise back. And if you put in a regular, just like a plain old egg, then it has the same chances of being a silver or gold or normal quality mayonnaise as any other quality egg does. So it's always better to just put in the base quality and sell the higher quality stuff. Because you might be losing money if you don't. Right, we had the tapper. So we're gonna go throw that on the maple tree. And we can also use the look up anything mod that I have here to look up when the next harvest date for the maple syrup is going to be. So let's just find those other maple trees. They're totally all the way over here, aren't they? Oh, nope. here. And then that's gonna take, oh god, it's longer than I thought. 9 days. Crap. That's okay. We'll be able to look, get our honey that we need before the winter, which is good. Because then we don't have to worry about honey for the next year. Now, the best thing that you can put are fairy roses. And you sit your little beehive near it. It gives you the best quality or the most expensive honey that you can, which is called fairy rose honey. And that sells for quite a bit, if I remember correctly. Alright, let's take a look here. Right, and you need to put that in the community center. Basic fertilizer we have. Speed grow. Alright. Let's just fill up puffballs. Water and hop on in to bed. And we don't need to worry about watering our crops the next day because it's going to be raining. Ugh, coffee. Nom 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 nom. In my Donald Duck mug. Gathering data on the correlation between soil, alkalinity, and crop fructose levels. Long story short, need a fresh melon from your farm. If you brought me one, I'd be very grateful. Well, we're growing melons, so you're in luck, Demetrius. What do we got here? Ooh, blueberries are done. Okay, let's see. They sell for 55. Which may not seem like a lot. But because of how many we just got, we got 30. And we only need one for the summer crops. We need to ship 15 of them as well, and then ship one. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So that's done. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to take the mixed seeds out, put one blueberry in there. And how long you guys got left? Hot pepper jelly. 2 days and 50 minutes. 2 hours and 10 minutes. 2 days, 1 hour. 8 hours, 40 minutes. 8 hours, 20. 8 hours, 20. Okay, so by the end of the day, or even, you know, before the end of the day, we will have enough, or we will have the pickled tomatoes done, and we will start throwing the blueberries in there for the jelly, but because the hot peppers are almost done, and apparently turn into jelly, which I didn't know about, it's a fruit, apparently, we will be able to put that in the community center in the artisan bundle. So already, we have what we need for the goat cheese, we just need the cheese maker. We're working on the honey. We're going to have the jelly. So 1, 2, 3. We're gonna have 3 spots filled up. And oh, we need to go check the little cave, because sometimes it has tree fruit in there. Which means that we don't have to worry about buying any more trees. And would you look at that? That is awesome. A cherry and an orange. So that takes... Yep, we're gonna have that done already. That's amazing. That makes me so happy. Oh. One less thing to worry about. Now. Pantry is good. Don't need to worry about any of that. We still need to worry about the animal bundle, but that is thankfully not a season-exclusive thing, so we don't need to worry about that immediately. We're working on the corn, we're working on the melons. We will have the pumpkin done next time. Excuse you, Thunder, I was talking. So let's go put those fruit into the community center right now so that we don't forget and accidentally sell them or something like that, because I've done it before. I'd rather not do it now, because we lucked out with what we got in that cave. And that's why it's so much better to have the fruit bats than it is to have the mushrooms. Because you can get just a crap ton of mushrooms during the fall anyway, so it's just not worth it. Blueberries are done. Now we just need the melon and the tomatoes. And animal bundle. Perfect. Now we do need a barn. And if I remember correctly, that's only 4,000. Or is it 6,000? Something along those lines. We're really close to it either way. Let's pop up here. Because Robin's going to be opening soon. Alright, Robin. What do I need for a barn? 6,000, 350 wood, and 150 stone. And we're not gonna buy it, because it's expensive to buy the materials when there's so many materials on our farm. Now, can I chop this down? Ooh, yes I can. Good. Gets it out of the way. Because I can't see behind it very well. It's better just to move it. Now it's gonna take us a couple days to get all the wood that we need, just because we don't have an upgraded axe, and if I spend the money on it, that's gonna be another 1,000 wood that we need for only 2 hits taken off of the tree. It's just not worth it unless I have all the extra money. Or if I have 6,000 gold laying around to upgrade it twice, which we don't because we need 6,000 for the barn. Oop. Grapes. Almost missed the grape. The grape actually is a pretty decent amount of energy back, 38. I think it's just a tad bit more effective than spice berry. Why is there logs in my chicken coop? Hello, chickies. Chicky, 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 chicky. Alright, look at that, gold quality. And we did put only low quality eggs in there, so. And there's the pickled tomato. That one's done. And throw it on in there. There's nothing else you can do with it. One blueberry. One blubbery. Alright, how much wood? 108. Still need 242. I can math, I swear. Best thing about the scythe is it doesn't require energy to use. There is a mod that I saw that's harvest all crops with a scythe. And yeah, it's totally useful, but I don't know if I'd want to do that just because it makes it seem like maybe a little too easy. Now let's cut down some of these pine trees after we get rid of all this grass that's sitting in the way. These little shrubs and whatnot, you can cut them down, but I can't recall if they grow back or not. And personally, I don't want to make this place look, you know, dead. Just because it is such a nice looking area. That I don't actually own this land. Not worried about the sap. It's useful for soil, but you can get it so easily. In fact, fact, I don't think I've ever made my own fertilizer, just because it's, especially the one that I would use, which is the higher quality one, if I recall correctly, requires a fish. And so it's like, oh, okay. I gotta catch 15 fish, which isn't really that difficult, but I'm just lazy. So I just go and buy it. Debris. Alright, 81. We're getting there. We're getting there. Probably another day or so, and we'll be able to have the wood that we need. Then it just comes down to the stone, which I think we've got a pretty decent amount already sitting in the storage box, and if not, then we just run down into the mine. Or we crack open the big stones that are sitting around. Because they give 10 stone each. And then tomorrow we're going to come back here so that we can check the cart again, because it shows up every Friday and Sunday, and see if they have anything else for the community center that we can use and save time on. I mean, heck, we might even come across, like, cloth or wool or a duck egg or something that helps save us money. Let's eat the salmon berry. Do we need the blackberry for anything? Yes, for the fall foraging. Grape? No. Not right now, anyway. See? Oh, 15! Better off just clearing all these out right now. A couple of it fell into the water. It really sucks when that happens, because it's like, oh, all my energy spent, and I'm not getting what I worked for. Can't move those stumps until we upgrade to an iron hatchet. Hatchet? Axe. Okay. So, just so mixed up with what they call it. Sometimes they call it a hatchet, sometimes a hand axe, sometimes an axe. Nope. We'll ship those and ship that. I don't think what this is used for anything. No. We're gonna hold on to the blackberry because we need that for the community center. Alright. We've got 117 and 205. Now. Bug meat. We can use that for bait. What else we got here? Geodes. What is our luck today? Crap.
Whoops!
Could have gone and got things, cracked open, but oh well. Tundra boots we don't need anymore. Cobblestone path, why is it just sitting there? The goat's milk goes in there for now. And blackberry, that way I don't sell it. That should go there. Okay, and we have no energy left. Get the mayonnaise from the chickies. And we'll go and throw this into the community, or not the community, the trading bin. We're also going to throw the coffee in there. Why? Because it grows so fast, we get so much of it from every plant. Now, what's the weather going to look like tomorrow? Awesome! Another day we don't have to water our crops. Oh, look at that money we got. 33.38. Awesome. Now all we need are the resources. And we can go get the axe upgraded, too. So we're gonna do that, because we got 5 copper. Okay, is anything ready? Yes. The radish. Radish. Okay, we're gonna ship one, sell the other. See, look at that. Coffee beans, again. 27, 28. And some hot peppers. What's this? The hot pepper jelly, 17 hours. Alright, should sell one radish. Sell the sweet pea. Actually, I'll hold on to it. It's good for gifting. Sell coffee. And we'll hold on to the hot peppers, because they're used in a recipe for something that's really good. What's our luck today? Somewhat annoyed. Okay. So we're not cracking anything open today. Let's get rid of this rusty sword. Actually, wait, no, I think we need it. Yeah, we still need it. What am I doing? We're probably better off making a new storage bin. We'll do that after. So we almost have enough stones. We'll just grab the last bit that we need here. Oh, and look at that, an artifact spot. Which has no artifact. Lies. Alright, how much stone do we have? 42. Okay, so we need 8 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alright, that's done. Now for the trees. We had 205, so we need 145, or we need, yeah, 145. Get rid of all the debris. Ugh, can't wait to get rid of that giant stump. Ooh, look, iron. Go and grab that ore. That way it keeps this area cleared. Oh, it's Sunday too. So we're gonna go check the cart and we have some excess money that we can use. If we find anything that we need. A peach sapling, a sandfish, a pufferfish, an eel, a battery pack. Did I need the eel still for the fishy tank? Yes, I do. And we can't get those anymore because those are in spring. So we're going to grab it. Still have extra money for the axe upgrade, which we will get to before the smithy closes today. But I want to do it now, do the trees now, because we have to wait 2 days for the axe to be done, and I don't want to wait longer than I have to for that barn. 66. Alright, so we need another 100. About. It's quite windy today. Those trees are going crazy out there. Alright, only 48 more. We'll have enough time to go to Robin's, get that set up, run to the blacksmith, get the axe upgraded. Making me very happy. What's... Oh. There we go. Gosh dang grass. Being so thick and getting in my way. Where's that weeds? I can't remember. Alright. 9 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so we're gonna go to Robin's now. And then we're gonna go to the blacksmith. We got left on the melons. 3 days. We've also got some hops growing, which is used for pale ale, once we have the kegs. And it sells for 300 gold per pale ale, so it's actually quite profitable. And I totally didn't grab the stone and wood that I needed. We might not get to the blacksmith today, which is quite annoying, but that's my fault. Do we have everything? Yes, we do. Run, Tethys! Run! You're not running, you're walking! This is walking! You're being too slow for me. Okay. Now. Let's put the barn right here. That's right, you will. Okay, if we make it to the blacksmith, it's gonna be really close. Sure, we can do it. Come on.
Yay! We did it! We did it!
We don't have enough money? Why you do this to me, Clint? Why? Well, that's slightly annoying. But dash on me. Oh well, we'll get it done tomorrow. Not like we need the axe for anything immediate anyway. Oh, we should go put this eel into the community center so we don't have to worry about it later. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Night fish bundle up. Okay. What's this? The ruby. Okay, well, we'll get him that ruby when we get a ruby. I would love it if it's still raining tomorrow too, but I think I might be asking too much. Hello, Puffball. Queen of Sauce. Maki rolls. We need that for the community center, and of course it's gonna be sunny. Blah. Hello, chickies. My fine feathered friends. We also need to save some money for a cow. Only one cow. Boop, 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 boop. Nothing too much today. Weather report? Raining tomorrow at least, so we don't need to worry about watering tomorrow. Yay, we got the jelly. Hot pepper jelly. Selling one. Blueberry jelly will be done soon. Poppies are done. Do I still need one for the menu center? I do. Tomatoes are done. Get rid of that sap. Awesome. Now, start watering. Thank you. Why? Want to buy better watering can. Thankfully, tis Monday. And I have enough money for the pickaxe upgrade this time. Yay! Robin's working on the barn. Go see our chickies. They are happy outside with their grass. Should be able to put mayonnaise in the community center because it is an artisan good. Okay, sell one poppy. Hold on to the other. I think what we're going to do today is we are going to, once we get the pickaxe, or the axe, to the blacksmith, we are going to go into the mines and try to get to level 80. And then we can hopefully get the fire forts and have the mine carts done. Alright, off to the blacksmith we go. Do I sell my copper? Yes, I do. Actually, let's quickly empty our inventory here. Hold on to that. Perfect. All right. Mayo. We'll go to the community center on the way to the mine, so we can drop off the jelly and the artisan bundle. Now upgrade my copper axe. Oh shoot, we forgot to go. Oh well, I'll do it on the way home. Hello, Linus. Ooh, hello, artifact possible spot. Eh, bye bye, book. Crap. It bounced off me. Floor 75. Skellies. Diamond spot. I'm curious to see how much experience it's gonna give if it gives more than other ones. Oh, whew, yes, it does give quite a bit of experience. Holy crap. Although, quite honestly, mining and combat is probably the easiest ones to level. because you're just always passively, not passively, but you're getting it just by doing what I'm doing here. XP pair. How much life do you have anyway? 82. Okay. Save me! Thank you. Amethyst. Back off. Back off. Haha! I win! Now I gotta find that next staircase. One more. Aha! Now, fire cords, please. Alright, these are gonna take a little bit more to break through because we're on a lower level where we're gonna find gold now. Bad. It just means that it's going to take a little more energy now. Let's see how much experience we get. Not bad. Nope. We're not playing this game. Nope. Fire quartz! Yes! And ruby! Emerald. What is our luck today? That would explain it. Okay, we're leaving. Nope. We're done. I'm gonna go to the community center, get that minecart business done, and then we can go to the wizard's place and give him the ruby that he needs. And we're gonna sell everything else that we found. Demetrius is deep in thought about me. Let's get the minecarts done. That's the first part of the community center done. Success. We are the Junimos keepers of the forest.
Ding.
And he just kind of follows you around until you leave the place. I wish that they would kind of continue to follow you even after. What are you doing, Linus? Grr, sounds like those raccoons are back again, filthy varmints. Ah, you turned up at the right moment, son. Could you do an old man a favor? Could you go around the corner and scare off those raccoons for me? They've been causing a real mess. Thanks. Make sure you give them a good scare so they never come back. It was me. I'm sorry. I find a lot of hot, fresh food in these cans. Stuff that will go to waste if I don't take it. Do you think there's something wrong with what I'm doing? No, but you should get a job and stop leeching off others. It's a shame for food to go to waste. Thanks, Tethys. I knew you were an open-minded person. I feel good about what I'm doing. I'm not harming anyone. You can go on home. I promise I won't rummage in George's can anymore. You can tell him you scared off the raccoons for good. Wait. I know what you were doing, Linus. If you need food, just ask. I don't want anyone in Pelican Town to go hungry. Here, I've got a basket of zucchini fritters for you. Just make sure you dip them in my spicy marinara. Go on, take it. Can't imagine being homeless like that. Ugh. Having to rummage through people's garbage. God, that's just... I couldn't do it. Alrighty. Got some more. We've got. Oh, I put the tomatoes in here, right. 1, 2, 3. Oh, could have gotten 4. Oh well. Grab that really quick. The weird old kid. Some mayo. and sell that. And the minecart will be done. And sleep. That's them fixing the minecart. I did something. What happened? I think I got an achievement, but I don't know what one. Is it for making a certain amount of money? No, it is raining today. Good. Earn 50,000. Well, that's probably what we got. Yep. Let's see if we got any crops finished. Yep, we do. Awesome. Well, we'll come back and we'll deal with that next time. So, thanks for watching, everybody. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and leave a comment in the comment section below, letting me know what you saw, what you want to see, if there's anything you'd like me to focus on more. Otherwise, I will continue on my happy little way. And if you liked what you saw and you want to see more of it, go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button so that you can keep up to date with all the videos that I post. Thanks again for watching. Bye! So let's throw down our fertilizer. Then throw down... Ah, shite! Ah, it's okay. Oh, well. Can I actually, like, get the seed back? Nope.
Oopsie!
Oh well. Live and learn. Okay, so we've got that planted.